Would you like to really benefit from the advanced mode of QuickBooks desktop bank feeds? Well, then you should watch this video, Advanced Rules for Recording Transactions. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The additional functionality of the advanced mode allows you to make rules that can add a customer job to a transaction and also allows you to add a class to a transaction. But what would be considered an advanced rule? An advanced rule would be a rule with more than one condition and have two ways to operate. You could make an advanced rule with one additional condition by using an end statement, which means all conditions in the rule must be true in order for the transaction to be recorded with that rule. The other way to make a complex rule is to use an OR statement. That means that any one of the conditions listed in the rule must be true in order for that transaction to be recorded with that rule. End statements, what does that mean? It means the rules must have all conditions true in order for a transaction to be recorded with that rule. For example, let's imagine we want to record all the transactions that start with the word ATM and also do not contain the word withdrawal. That's the rule. You see, if we look right now at the review list and we type in the word ATM, we can filter with just that word and you can see that many of them have the word withdrawal in them, but many do not. Notice down here, this does not. Notice down here, this does, but if you keep going, you'll get to ones that don't. We want only the ones that start with ATM, but do not contain the word withdrawal. So since both conditions must be true, it has to start with ATM and also not contain the word withdrawal in order for that transaction to be recorded with that rule. So once we determine this, what do we want the rule to do? We want the rule to change the payee of the transaction to staples, and we want to change the account on the rule to supplies. And thirdly, because we're in advanced mode, we want to change the customer job to Eddie Edwards. Now, if we come up here and click rule, and we get the rule list, in the top right, we click add rule. Now, we can name it ATM as the name of the rule, and that's fine. But what exactly are we looking at here? Well, you can see that the top section has the text that the rule is based on, whereas the bottom section of this window determines what you want, or this is the place that you tell QuickBooks, this is what you want the rule to do to any transaction that fits the conditions above. Now, of course, we have to name the rule in order to save it on the list. And of course, this rule is in regard to money out because it discusses ATM withdrawals and so on. But this is the most important choice to make, and you will see making this choice determines how the rule behaves. So we want the rule to make it such that it will record the things we want it to record if the transaction description field or any of the text fields mentioned begin with the word ATM. And now we have to add the second condition. Look what happens when we click Add Line. The word OR shows up here. Now, we don't want it to record the transaction in the way we're going to describe if it has either ATM or does not contain the word withdrawals. Because if we leave it with OR, it means that if something simply does not contain the word, here, look, does not contain the word spelled exactly like that, that means if we leave it as any, if we leave it with an OR statement, it means that every single transaction on the list that simply does not have this word anywhere in the text fields will be recorded with this rule. And that's not right. We want transactions only that have ATM and also do not have the word withdrawals. So by changing the criteria to all, we have made this an and statement instead of an or statement, which means both of these things must be true for the transaction to be changed and recorded under this rule that we're making now. It has to begin with the word ATM and not contain the word withdrawals. Now, down here, we're going to tell it what we want it to do. Make the payee staples, because we take out cash to buy supplies, and that's why we're going to make the account become supplies expense. And the customer that relates to that, or the job that relates to that, would be Eddie Edwards from the pull-down list. So this is what the rule will look like, and in the bottom right, you would click Save. And when we come back to the bank feeds window, we can see that 6 out of the 570 some odd transactions were changed by that specific rule. 568 still remain the same way that they were, but we can click here as soon as we save the rule. Any of the transactions that are under that rule will show up in the recognized instead of the unrecognized. And notice they're all selected by click because it clicks the top left automatically for you. But before you select it, you should notice that all of the payees have been changed to staples. See? All of the accounts for each of these 6 transactions have been changed to supplies expense, and the customer job was changed to Eddie Edwards under Dave Deeney. So it's a little squashed. I think I might be able to open it up and show you. If you make the column wider, first of all, you can see that only the ones that have the word AT&T and do not have the complete word withdrawal, because it cuts it off here, you have to be careful, the rule is according to the text. But what you'll notice is it followed the rule by making all of the payee staples, all of the categories of the accounts become the supplies expense account here, and the customer job, Dave Deeney. So we're a little out of room, but you can see it's Dave Deeney, it's Eddie Edwards under Dave Deeney. So you might have a little trouble opening up the width to really see the names of the columns, but basically it fulfills the criteria of the rule. Now, if you want to enter all of these, of course, it's very simple. We learned in previous videos that of the ones that are following the rule or filter or whatever can be all selected and deselected. So if you click recognize these 6, that means when you click the top check mark, only these 6 are recognized. Click Batch Actions, Add Confirm, and then click Yes, and then they all get recorded. And you have 568 to work with to make other rules to enter them quickly as well. Now let's try an example with an OR statement. An OR statement is a rule that must have any condition true in order for a transaction to be recorded with that rule. For example, Let's imagine we want to record all the transactions that start with the word check or contain the word fee. Now, what does that mean? It means that if it only starts with the word check but does not contain the word fee, it will still be included when it's recording all the transactions in that rule. What else does it mean? It means if even if it does not start with the word check, if it does contain the word fee, that means that it will also be included in the rule because at least one condition was true. Of course, if both conditions are true and it contains both, then obviously that transaction will be included with the rule. And if you're using an or statement, it means that in order for a transaction to not be in the rule, both of them have to be not true. So only transactions that do not start with the word check and do not contain the word fee will not be included in the rule if the rule contains an or statement. So what do we want the rule to do? We want the rule to change the payee to Chase. We want the rule to change the account to bank fees expense. And we also want to change the class to class B. And these are the things that we want the rule to do as soon as we save the rule on the list. So again, we click Rules, Add Rule, and this one would be called Chase Fee. Now, again, it relates to money out because we're talking about fees, but instead of choosing all, this time we make sure we choose any. And the description should contain the word fee, and it can also either begin with the word check. So notice, it says any of these conditions, which means it can either contain the word fee or begin with the check. And what do we want it to do? We want to rename the payee to Chase. We want to put it as the category of bank fees expense down here. And the class that it will belong to is class B. So now we made a rule that will apply to a class or make it choose a specific class. Now, when we save the rule, the interesting part happens when we close the rule list and we come back that 35 of the transactions were changed by this rule. Here are the ones that were not changed by the rule. And when we click in the left center the word recognized, we can see the 35 transactions that were changed by this rule. Notice, they all have the payee as Chase, they all have the account bank fees, and they're all in class B. And they're all selected by clicking this top check mark here, so all 35 can be entered at once, batch actions, add confirm, and then just click yes for the warning message, and you can see these 35 have now been entered successfully into the register and into the QuickBooks records. Click OK, and now you're free to make another rule for the remaining ones until they all get recorded quickly and easily.